HTTP unit tools, guys. So let us try to understand what is Marketo. First we'll study Marketo, then we will go for HTTP unit. Fine. It is built on the top of JUnit, guys. It is built on the top of JUnit tool. Sir, we are happy with JUnit. We are able to do unit testing perfectly in JUnit in all permutation and combination. Why should I go for what? Marketo. It is given to mark the objects. It is given to perform unit testing by marking the dependent or local dependent or external dependent objects. Local dependent or external dependent objects. I'll explain what is this, guys. You have a service class. Service is having dependency with what? DAO class. Everyone knows this, na? Service class is there. Service will have dependency with what? DAO class. So this DAO will talk with the database software. Yes, guys. DAO will talk with the database software. Service class contains what, guys? Business methods. Having business logic. DAO will have what? Persistence methods. Having persistence logic. Okay, guys. Fine, boss. Service class methods internally calls DAO class method. Let us assume DAO class is not ready because of some database issues, because of some other issues. Okay, DAO class is not ready, but service class fellow has completed his logic and he want to do unit testing. Because if by completing unit testing, you want to focus on other service class development. But DAO class fellow, since he is having some issues with the database or some other personal reasons, he has not completed DAO. But service class fellow wants to complete what is a task. And he want to complete unit testing. He want to hand over the work and he want to move to another work. Come on, guys. So at that time, service class fellow should create mock objects of what? Mock means dummy, duplicate, fake objects. Come on, guys. Mock objects means dummy, duplicate, fake objects temporarily, not permanently, to complete the unit testing of the service class or not. Array, the word mock is very popular in real life also. Okay. Before writing real engineering entrance test, there will be mock exams, boss. Model exams, mock exams, which are not real exam, but it looks like a real exams. Are you understanding my point there? Before doing real car driving, there will be mock driving environment, virtual driving environment. So that he can learn some basics of driving in a virtual driving environment. Right, before attending actual interview, come on. Before going for actual interview, come on. Okay, we will be giving mock interviews to your working friends, relatives. Fake interview. Mock interview means fake, dummy interview, which looks like real, but not actually real. Which gives the feeling of real, but actually not real. What is the advantage of mock interview, guys? what is the advantage of mock interview? You can feel there is an interview, okay, but you are not worried about outcome of the result. It builds your confidence. You will get the experience. If you are having interview phobia, you will come out of that interview phobia. Come on, guys. I hope you are understanding my point there. Okay, guys, tell me. Let us assume DAO class code is not ready. Coding is not completed. Very important. First, try to understand why we should go for Marketo. DAO class coding is not completed. But service class coding is completed and we want to finish unit testing. We want to finish unit testing of service class. Okay. Then we need to create mock object, nothing but fake object or dummy object for DAO class, okay, and inject to service class in order to write test case, in order to write test cases on service class methods, right? I think you got a need of DAO, guys. Okay, so let's take one more scenario. Another scenario, okay, guys. Here we are having sharecon.com service class. I think everyone knows what is sharecon.com. Sharecon.com is a website, a stock brokering website here, right? Sharecon.com service. Oh, 1 minute. I think I have not taken new paintbrush. Just a minute, guys. I supposed to take a new paintbrush. Yeah, let me save this document, guys. Class content, tools. Marketo. What is December 12th? Marketo on December 10th. Please switch on your cameras. Otherwise, I will remove you from the meeting, guys. Please switch off your cameras. Sharecon.com service class, guys. Okay, to get the share value and to display the share value, it has got the dependency with BSE stock exchange component, Bombay stock exchange component, which is a external component. What component? External component, which is also called distributed application. There will be network, guys. There will be network. Are external component na, guys? Okay. Right. This is one. Sharecon.com website is having its own service class. to have a business method, right, guys? Now tell me, guys, at the time of development only we will have tie up with BSE stock exchange? Mostly not. Once everything is ready, okay, because BSE people will charge money, guys. You have a plan of launching this website after 1 year, but before 1 year only development started. Before 1 year only development started, what you will do by taking subscription 1 year before? Okay, if you take subscription 1 year before, they will charge from day one. Unnecessarily waste of money or not? Unnecessarily waste of money or not? I want reply from you people. After 1 year, we take the subscription when a project is about to get into production. But in this 1 year, whatever communication that should happen with BSE component, okay, we have to keep in mind and we have to do communication. But so instead of that, we have to create one mock BSE component and we have to inject to service class of sharecoin.com and you have to complete the unit testing process and testing process are not there. When real launch happens, come on, guys. When real launch happens, that time we will take the subscription and we will go for real communication with the BSE component. So final conclusion is, when sharecoin.com is under development, okay, it's practically impossible to take the subscription of BSE component, which is a chargeable. So until we take the subscription with BSE component, it's better to have one mock object of BSE component and that should be injected to sharecoin.com service class in order to perform unit testing. That means even though dependent is not there, we should give the feeling there is a dependent and our code is running smoothly so that we have to go forward unit testing. Okay, Vamsi Deepak is asking, after listening entire story, why we should do, sir? They charge money. BSE component people will charge money when you go for subscription. So in the development, when business is not there, who will pay the money? There is no question of paying money, right? So that's why we have to create what? Mock object or duplicate object or fake object for BSE component. So people are not listening with focus. After listening entire Ramayana, people are asking me why, sir, what, sir? That means they are not focusing. Please focus. Right. So for that reason, better to have a mock object for BSE component or not there. Right, guys. Okay, guys. Sharecoin.com website is under development. Sharecoin.com website is under development. We cannot. Okay. Under development. We cannot take subscription of BSE component because they charge use money for that. So generally this subscription will be taken after hosting or releasing sharecoin.com. Okay, so till that time we need to take we need to take one mark BSc component and assign to service class of sharecon.com. Service class of sharecon.com. Understanding my point, service class of sharecon.com to perform unit testing. I hope you are understanding my point there, right? Okay, everyone understanding my statement? What is mock object, guys? Okay, it is a technically looks like a real object, but actually not. I hope you are understanding my statement. Okay. Temporary looks like a duplicate alternate object. For the timing, we inject that object to our main class and we complete the task. We definitely complete the task. Yes, one more thing. One module is having dependency with other module. For example, purchase module is having dependency with payment module. Everyone concentrate. But payment module is still not ready. Purchase module is ready. So we have to continue the flow in order to complete unit testing of purchase module. Okay, that time also we can create mock objects for the payment module classes or not. We can create mock objects for payment module classes or not. I hope you are understanding. Because we are, see boss, payment module work is going a bit slow. Why? Because many programmers have taken leave, our team is not there properly, our team member is having marriage issue or some other personal problem. That's why work is going very slowly. And some bug is there, they're fighting with some problem. And whereas purchase module, things are happening very fastly. So purchase module people cannot wait until payment module is completely ready in order to complete their coding, in order to complete their unit testing, in order to submit the task, in order to move to another module or other work to develop. So meanwhile, what they need to do, they create some mock objects for payment module scenarios or payment module classes, and they will assign to purchase module objects and they will complete the unit testing. So they will definitely complete unit testing. So mocking is all about keeping the things as fake or duplicate objects, though real objects are not ready. I hope everyone understood the real meaning of mocking, boss. What is need of creating mock objects? This point is registered in your brain or not brain? Registered or not registered? If this is registered, I can move further. Okay, guys. Mock objects. Yes. Mock objects are for temporary. For temporary needs. Mostly they will be used. In the unit testing. I hope you are understanding my point there. Okay, fine. Mostly they will be used in unit testing, right? These mock objects created in test methods are test case class does not affect real code. Real code really does not affect real code, boss. So tomorrow real one comes, something happens, will not happen. These mock objects will be there only in what? Okay. Test methods and test case classes. When real work is ready, they will not disturb the actual flow. Understanding my statement, guys? Right. Fine. Okay, guys. We can do this marking. We can do this marking in three ways. We can do this marking in three ways. Number one, using mock object, nothing but fake object. Fake object. Understanding my statement? Using mock object are nothing but fake object. Right. Okay. Provides temporary object. That's it. Next, using stubs. Okay, boss. Providing some functionalities for the methods. Functionality for the methods. Okay, boss. Using stub object, providing some functionalities for the methods of mock object, like specifying for certain inputs, certain output should come. For certain input, certain output should come. Yes, stub means what I can say, like proxy kind of thing, boss. It's a stub means what I can explain. It is also one kind of proxy object, one kind of mock object, but having some functionality to perform. Next, number C, using spy object. Using spy object. Okay, guys. Right, using spy object. It is called partial mock object or half mock object. That means okay, if you provide new functionality to method that will be used. Otherwise, real object will be used. I hope you are understanding my point. If you provide your own functionality, that will be used. Otherwise, real object functionality will be used. But one thing you remember, guys, okay, while working with the spy object, we must have real object also. That means we have to be ready with real object. So that's why spy object is not regularly used, boss. Simple theory. When you are ready with the real object, why don't you go for real object? I hope you are understanding my point there. Okay, we can happily think about going for real object or not. Come on. Otherwise, real object functionality will be used. If you need new functionality to method, if you provide new functionality to method, that will be used. Otherwise, real object functionality will be used, guys. Okay. Note, spy object, we will be having real object also. Real object also. Everyone got the clarity, guys? Okay, we can do marking in three ways. Using mark object or fake object provides just a temporary object. Using stub object, same as mark object, but provides some functionalities to the methods. If this input is given, this output should come. Wait, and when I give code, you will get the idea. Please don't come to one conclusion. Lastly, using spy object, it is a half mark object or partial mark object. Half mark object or partial mark object. Understanding my point. If you provide new functionality to the method, it will be taken. If you don't provide new functionality, it don't mind using a real functionality on the real object. Real functionality on the real object. So these are the three ways of doing marking, boss. Everyone got the clarity? Yes, you are going to experience all of them. Nothing to worry. I'm going to teach in two ways, boss. Okay, guys. Now, tell me, boss. Instead of doing this marking process manually by taking our own classes, okay? So we have framework who can generate these mark objects, stub objects, spy objects dynamically, automatically at runtime. So they are called marking frameworks, guys. And we have multiple marking frameworks in the market. Understanding my point there? Yes, we can create these duplicate classes, creating mark objects, fake objects for them, creating what? Duplicate classes, having a new functionality on temporary basis with hard-coded inputs, with hard-coded outputs, and linking new class with what, real class, and all these things we can do manually, guys. But doing that work manually is a complex process. So we have some framework who can generate this kind of what, mark classes dynamically at what time? Runtime. We can generate these mock classes dynamically at runtime as in-memory classes. The people who have done with Spring and Hibernate with me, they are aware of what is in-memory classes. Come on. They will be created dynamically at runtime in the memory where application runs. That's why they are called as what? In-memory classes. Understanding my point? Instead of creating classes manually, okay, to prepare mark, comma, stub and spy objects, okay, objects we can use marking frameworks available in the market. Marking frameworks available in the market, okay, which are capable of generating such classes, what is this, dynamically at runtime as in-memory classes. What classes? In-memory classes. The classes that are generated in the JVM memory of RAM. They are called in-memory classes, guys. Okay, first of all, tell me, you have a .java file. When you compile, you will get .class file. Okay, when you execute, JVM takes the this one, you will get the output. This is the basic story now, guys. Okay, tell me where .java file is there? Hard disk drive. Where our .java file is there? Hard disk drive. You can touch it, we can feel it, right? Hard disk drive. Understanding my point there. So what is in memory class, guys? In memory class, very important, concentrate. In memory class, okay. In memory class, source code, that means in fact .java kind of thing. Yeah, where it will be there? JVM memory. Where it will be there, guys? JVM memory, RAM. It will be RAM. Class source code generation happens in the RAM. Can we feel it? No. Next, bytecode. Where bytecode will be there, guys? Where bytecode will be there? Again, JVM memory. Nothing is visible. So far, we have seen object creation in the RAM boss. But I'm saying class generation, class compilation, and okay, there itself it will take JVM. Understanding my point? Okay, sir. Okay, JVM and output will come. JVM and output will come. Yeah, the JVM will create the object and all this stuff will happen. See, this is regular classes, guys, normal classes. But in-memory classes are different. They are generated at what time? Runtime. Where in the JVM memory? Come on. Okay. Like lambda expressions code also. Same thing. Next one. Their compilation is happened at what time? Runtime. Where in the JVM memory? Execution happens at what time? Runtime. Output comes at runtime. Okay. That's why they are called in-memory classes. In-memory class. Are Spring people, Hibernate people, I already discussed. In Hibernate Spring, that name is called proxy class, right? This kind of classes are called as what? Proxy classes. Okay. Now, these frameworks, the marking frameworks that are there in the market are capable of giving classes of mock objects, stub objects, spy objects in the form of in-memory classes. What classes, guys? In the form of in-memory classes. In the form of in-memory classes. Okay, guys. JVM creates the object and uses that object and gives the output, guys. Everyone got the clarity here? Convinced with me, guys? Okay, this entire thing is runtime, boss. This entire thing is runtime. Everything is runtime. Entire class comes at runtime, guys. Entire class comes at runtime. Okay, guys. Next, here what? Up to this compilation, and this is runtime. Come on, guys. This is compile time, and we can feel them, right? And this is runtime. Only object creation, execution, getting output happens at runtime. Class development, class compilation, okay, .java, .class files happens at compile time. We can feel them. Come on, guys. Feel them. Compile time and development time, guys. Okay, we can see them. But here, class generation, class compilation, giving that class to JVM, object creation, output generation, everything happens at what time? Runtime. That's the reason these are called in-memory classes. In-memory classes. And one more surprise fact, you know? All this happens while running another normal class, guys. All these happens, all these things happens, all these things happens, happen while running normal other class or application. When you run normal application, normal class, okay, while executing that normal class, normal application, internally these things also will take place. See the beauty, sir. How runtime will be there without normal class? Definitely runtime is there, means one or other normal application, normal class is running or not running. Definitely running, guys. Okay, so let it be. You will feel it, you will feel it. Okay guys, now tell me marking frameworks. Now I want to give list of marking frameworks. List of marking frameworks. Tell me. Right, we have a lot of names are there. Markito. Okay, J Markito. Easy Mark, Power Mark. Okay, and etc. But most popular one is industry standard is Markito only. Popular one is Markito only. Everyone in the industry prefers using what? Markito only. Okay, I think you got a requirement here. Don't come to one conclusion on Markito until I introduce it completely. Okay guys, so let us create one small application, guys. Okay, some example application. Example application setup. Example application setup. Let us assume. Okay. Let us assume. Who said Markito is instable, right? Entire industry is using Markito. Okay. Okay. Example application setup. Testing. Login service class. Login management service class without keeping login DAO class ready. Without keeping login DAO class ready. I hope you are understanding my point. I have a login service class, but I want to test, okay, without keeping login DAO class ready. I hope you are understanding my statement, guys. Right. Okay, step number one, what should I do? Step number one, what should I do? Create Maven project. I'm creating it as a standalone application only. Maven-archetype-quickstart. Same as last time, guys. Maven-archetype-quickstart. That's cool. Okay, here what is this? So I will try to give some example. Login application. Okay, login application using login application. Unit testing login app. Come on. Login app using Markito. Otherwise, I will put like this. Markito unit testing. Okay, login application. What is the default package, guys? What is the default package? com.nt.test. com.nt.test. Yes, we are ready with this gun. We are ready with this one. First of all, create Maven standalone application. Standalone application. Okay. What is the procedure, guys? File menu. Tell me. Maven project. Maven, guys. Maven project. Whatever it is. I don't remember these small things. Maven project, then tell me. Next, select Maven iPhone. Tell me, archetype iPhone quick start. Archetype iPhone 6 start. Group ID, NIT, generally organization name will be there. Artifact ID is the project name, guys. Don't think much. Okay. Marketo. What is this? Marketo. Login APP. Marketo unit testing. Login APP. Some name, guys. Okay. Next. Default package. Default package. com.nt.test. I think I want to take service class. Okay. I will tell what is that. No problem. You can take anything, guys. That's not an issue. Test package will come here. Will come here. I'm deleting this one, guys, because I want to keep my unit testing code here. Only here. Only here. So that's why I'm deleting from here. I'm keeping here. So that's why, since you decided to delete, that's why I'm asking to create default package as service, which won't be deleted. One default package, nothing, nothing. Okay, don't think much on it. Okay, go to pom.xml, change Java version to 13, or if you have a 15, 15. If you have a 16, 16. Okay. Okay. Maven update, that's a regular story. Maven update, save, okay. Yeah, it will change it to this. Next, go to pom.xml. Change dependency. JUnit 4 dependency is there. Try to add JUnit 5 dependency. From where you can collect, guys? mvnrepository.com. mvnrepository.com. What is the one I should write here? JUnit Jupyter. JUnit Jupyter API. Fine. 5.7 latest only I am taking. Yes. Right. This is the one thing here. Next we have Marketo Core, guys. Marketo Core. Marketo Core. 3.628, save paste. What is this? A Marketo Core. org.marketo core, Marketo Core 3.628. This is one more thing that is required, guys. These two are the jars that we have to add. Okay, guys. Step number two. Do following things, following operations, do following operations in pom.xml file. What dot xml file, guys? Form.xml file. Right. Number one, I think I'm changing. Change Java version to. Array, you have to read the documentations. Karanti is fine. How you know Oracle thin driver is there in OJDBC 6.0 documentation? Fine. You have to spend time. You have to read the documentation of those frameworks. Change Java version to 13. Yes, I'm not telling that one. Add following dependencies. Dependencies, okay, nothing but jars. Add following dependencies. What they are, guys? These two are the two dependencies I should add. Yeah, fine, boss. This is step number two. this is step number 2. Step number 3, guys. Yeah, Jupyter API, JUnit 5. Jupyter API, JUnit 5 you have to add. Don't keep surprising face. What we have added in the last session, same thing we are adding. Okay, if 13 is not present, whatever latest version is there, take it. 13 is not compulsory, guys. Right. Step number 3. Okay. Develop service class and DAO interface. Develop service interface, comma, service class and DAO interface. Yes, we have to develop DAO interface. Otherwise, what you will use in service class? There should be something in the service class to use now, guys. Implementation, we don't write saying that some problem. Okay, but we have to develop what service class? We have to develop interface, right? Okay, now let's see now. Let's see what I'm doing to do that. Okay, tell me, com.nt.service. Yes. Okay. Yeah, by creating package only we have to create, guys. Don't be that much innocent. Service.java interface. Login management service IMPL class. Login management. I think for safety purpose, take I. What is there in that? Next. That's the one thing. com.nt.dao, guys. Okay. Login.dao.java. Login.dao.java. Shall we start doing that, guys? Okay. So where we have to do all these operations? We need to do these operations in src/main/java folder. We have to do in this folder. Right, guys. Okay. Since we have to follow standard, I will take ilogin.dao to give the feeling it's the interface. Package com.nt.service. Nice. Package com.nt.dao. Done, guys. Okay. DAO interface. What is this? ilogin.dao. New. Okay. ilogin.dao. Here I will declare one method. What is the method? You know, public int authenticate string username, string password. That's it, guys. String username, string password. Super. So here we are having one more interface, guys. I login management service. I login management service. Here also I am having declaration of the methods, guys. Public string. Otherwise we'll take boolean every time string. Why? Okay, public, because login successful, true. Not successful, false. If any username passwords are not given, exception, illegal argument exception. Like this we will go for it. Fine. Please switch off your cameras. If not switched off, don't force me to remove from the meeting. Okay, guys. Public boolean. Tell me here. Public boolean. Login only I will give. Why all these things? Okay. String username, string password. Tell me, guys. Login method will call authenticate method. Authenticate method actually should talk with the database software to check whether these username passwords are correct or not by talking to table by verifying in the table. But right now we have some database issues. That's why we are not ready to develop what implementation class for DAO interface. But still we want to complete what service class login method development, and we want to do unit testing also. I think very, very interesting or not? Come on. Yes, guys. Let's see what I'm going to do here. Class here. Login management service IMPL. What is the interface? iLogin management service. Okay, guys. Right. Okay. Private iLogin DAO. iLogin DAO. Tell me. Login DAO. So I'm taking constructor, parameterized constructor to get to assign DAO to service, to assign DAO to service. Or you can take setter method. That's up to you. Your choice. Okay. Your choice, guys. I'm taking constructor and there I am passing what? iLogin DAO. DAO. this.login.dao is login.dao. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay, fine, boss. Now listen carefully. If username, if anything is empty string, guys, equals empty string. If username equals empty string or password equals empty string. If anything is given as, acha, 1 minute. Okay, now you are happier. Login DAO. Fine, guys. Arrays. Ashwin ready plus wait. Yeah, wait. Let me complete the code conditionally. Fine. So since boolean is there, for this condition no return is there, red color is coming. Once I do that, it will be gone. Throw new illegal argument exception. Okay, right. What is that? Empty credentials, or I'm just, credentials means username passwords. Empty credentials. Please focus. Empty credentials. Okay. Use DAO. What DAO? Login DAO. Use DAO. Fine, boss. Ashwanth Reddy, super class for all exception is IO exception. Huh? Okay, first correct your knowledge, then ask the question. Super class for exception is not IO exception. I think you better join in Core Java one more time. Okay, refer your Core Java books and correct yourself. Then think properly. Super class for all exception is not IO exception. Sorry to say. Right, guys. Fine, boss. And people are questioning you how you got placed in CTS company, boss. IO exception is related to what? IO streams. Please. Right, guys. Int count is equal to login DAO dot authenticate of username and password. Yes, guys. Tell me here. Tell me. Count to double equal to zero. Are when zero comes, guys? Invalid credentials. When you write real logic, when zero comes, invalid credentials. Else, return false. Return true. Else, return true. Overall, what is the thing, guys? This login method returns exception, illegal argument exception, if you don't submit username or password. Same login method returns true for valid credential. Return false for invalid credential. This is how I have written. See, since interface is there, though implementation class is not there, I have called the method. But do you really think this method is really implemented, guys? This method is really, code is there to execute, not there. So we have to do marking on this class or not. Marking on this login DAO or not. Come on. Right. Fine, boss. Shall we start doing that work now? Yes. Go to test package, guys. Go to test package. Here is my class. What is this? Login management service test. Login management service test. Fine, guys. Okay. Now tell me, what are the best two use cases, best test cases, test methods for login example, guys? Other than I have given, we should write test methods by quantity or by variety. We should write test method by quantity or by variety. Tell me, what are the variety methods? What are the different variety methods? Test with valid credentials, test with invalid credentials, test with no credentials. We have to test in all three angles or not. But in all the three times, we definitely need what object, guys? Login service object and mock object created for DAO also. Definitely we need mock object created for DAO, and we also need service object right now. So better to create in all the test methods, or better to create only for one time. Better to create all the test methods, or better to create only for one time. Yes. If you're thinking to create only for one time, yes, it's the extension of JUnit, guys. Definitely it's the extension of JUnit. So we can go for what? Before all and after all methods are not. But they should be taken as static methods. We know that. We all know that, right? Okay. Shall we go for it now? Okay. Fine, boss. Here, what is this story? Private static. Private static. Private static I login management service login service private static I login DAO I login DAO oh spell mistake here I login DAO login DAO. Yeah, please keep in one thing in mind. Please keep one thing in mind. Still, we are not ready with the implementation class of DAO, but we have to do unit testing on service class. Marking. We want to get a mock object created for DAO class, right? Okay. Public static void. Okay. Setup once. Other day we are habituated taking this kind of thing at the rate before all, right? Okay, set up once at the rate before all. Listen carefully. Okay. Now, are you going to have real login object or mock only, boss? Okay. Login DAO mock. I'm going to take a word called mock. Are we going to have a real one or mock one? Mock one. So that's why, listen. Login DAO mock is equal to login DAO mock is equal to here Mockito dot. There is a straight away method called mock. There is a straight away method called mock. Are you understanding my point? Okay, on which one? I login DAO. I login DAO dot class. Yeah, what this line will do, sir? Control plus shift plus O. What this line will do, sir? Takes this interface, internally generate in-memory class implementing this interface, internally generate in-memory class implementing this interface as a dummy class or fake class. As a dummy class or fake class, right? Having nothing in the authenticate method, no logic in the authenticate method, having nothing, nothing, nothing in the authenticate method. See, guys, sir, how can you say it is implementing login DAO interface? Or if it is not implementing, how I can able to refer with login DAO interface reference variable? I'm able to refer with login DAO interface reference variable are not there. Yes or no, na? Okay. Mock method generates in-memory class. What class, guys? In-memory class. At what time? Runtime. Anyhow, method execution happens at runtime. In-memory class. Implementing. What guys? I login DAO interface. If you pass class extending from that class, if you pass interface implementing that interface, I login DAO interface having null method definitions for authenticate method. Tell me, guys, it is creating mock object or not, guys? Okay, create mock or fake or dummy object. Create mock or fake or dummy object. Nothing. Just make sure that it is there. Tell me, am I doing this one in the real development environment or unit testing environment? These objects are visible in real for real service class, guys? No, we are just doing to complete the unit testing. Come on. We are just doing. If you want to see the source code, look at the mock. It's an interface method. It's an interface method, static method that is calling one more thing, one more mock. Okay, that is calling one more mock. Yes, here we are having this one. See this instance, get settings, implement build method. This build method is taking the story. This build method, create mock, marking progress, marking started. Come on, create mock. Create mock is having a lot of reflection API story, guys. Lot of reflection API story. Understanding my statement? A number of things will be there. You are least bothered. It uses a lot of libraries. But I can print the class name. I can print what methods are there, what interface is implementing by using my reflection API concept, boss. Right. Now tell me. You are just happy. You are just happy doing this, huh? You are just happy doing this, or you have to create service class object and you have to assign sorry, DAO object to service class object. Huh? Definitely you have to assign what? DAO object to service class object. Come on. Create service class object. Hey, service class, we are having implementation given by us guys. So there is no need of any mock object for service. Agree with me or not there? I login management service. Oh, already there, na variable. Okay. Login service is equal to new. Come on, guys. Come on. New I login management service. Not I login. Okay. Login management service. Login management service IMPL. Service IMPL. What is the class name I have taken, guys? Login management MGMT service IMPL. Login management service IMPL. Why it is not reflecting here, guys? Okay, it came. But we have to pass one constructor. What is that DAO it is offering? What I am passing? Mock object. I'm not ready with real object, and that's why I'm initializing mock object. This will execute only for one time now, guys. Come on. Right. So at the end of all test methods execution, better to nullify them or not? Better to nullify. This is extra. Mock object has come. Public static. Tell me. Void. Clear ones. Clear ones. At the rate after all, at the rate after all, tell me here, better to nullify, though it is a mock, what is the problem? I want to nullify it. Okay. Lock the AO. Next one, login service. Login service is equal to null. Yes, I nullified it. Now start writing test methods. Start writing what methods, guys? Test methods. Fine, guys. Okay. Generally, what we take, public void test login with valid credentials. Valid credentials. Test login with valid credentials. Fine, guys. Provide stub for. Okay. Mr. Rambabu Garu, please take care of. Rambabu Garu, please take care of waiting room. Rambabu Garu, please take care of waiting room.
Okay, sir.
Right. Okay, guys. Provide stub. Stub. That means stub means temporary functionalities. Temporary functionality. Stub means temporary, on behalf of something. Temporary functionality for login method. Okay. Provide stub temporary functionalities for login. Sorry, not login method. Okay. DAOs authenticate method. See, you will understand what is the difference between mock and stub. Mock means just dummy object. Okay. Stub means it will have some functionalities for the methods. For this input, this output should be there. Right. Now listen here. In Mockito, we have a lot of methods, guys. Mockito. Actually, you can use static imports also. Wantedly, I am not using to know what is what. Okay. Mockito dot when. Markito.when. Markito.when. When which method is called? Which method is called, guys? Logging DAO dot, login DAO mock dot, come on, authenticate method is called with Raja and Rani. Raja and Rani. If at all authenticate method is called on DAO, DAO object, mock DAO object with Raja Rani values, then return integer value 1. See, I'm providing stub or not. I'm providing sub. Actually, it is not real functionality, but I'm providing some temporary functionalities or not. I'm providing some temporary functionalities or not. Are you understanding my point, guys? Come on. Is it real functionality? No. If at all anyone calls authenticate method with what? Raja Rani. Then return one. Okay. So we have provided stub also for login method. Here, fake object is ready. Here I am providing stub. Okay, very okay. I think now that's what I said. Until you see practical, you never understand. When I introduced these three terminologies, someone said that, sir, give me some technical idea. I think now you got technical idea about mock object and stub object, right? Mock object means just a fake object. Fake object. But stub means what? If I give this input, that output should come. If I give this input, that output should come. Are you understanding my statement? Okay, actually not there. Mocking, guys. Right. Okay, then we have done stub, guys. Now, expect. Okay, now get actual result. Otherwise, why to waste? We will go for assert true. Assert to true condition. Anyhow, we are having login service dot. What dot, guys? Login service dot. Login method. I will try to give same username and password. Raja Rani. That's it. Okay. Unit testing. Yeah, now listen carefully. See this login service, login Raja, comma Rani. That's fine, guys. So it will go to this method. Is it empty? No exception. Then it calls login DAO dot authenticate Raja, comma password. Raja, comma password. Array, our service is injected with mock object. In the mock object, what I said. My service now injected with mock object. In the unit testing method, what I said, guys? Array, if someone calls authenticate method with Raja Rani, then return one. So here I'm, what I have given Raja Rani, here also Raja Rani, then count will give one or not. If you are not believing me, just check it out. Sys out. Service law. Okay. Service login method count plus is equal to count to give the feeling whether it is really coming or not. Now, if one comes, what happens, guys? If one comes, what happens? Return true. Yes, I am writing what test, guys? Assert true. This method returns true and checks for true has come or not. Yes, true has come. Test becomes positive or not. But do you have a DAO code with us? Do you really have a DAO code with us? In this example, you understood what is mock object, what is stub. Come on. I think you are understanding importance of marking. Similarly, purchase class is looking for payment class, but payment takes time to have a tie-up and to have a subscription. So till that time, you can create this kind of thing now, guys. If so and so so and so card number with so and so money is given, so and so message should come. Like this, I will write one dummy logic, right? Stub logic. Yeah, hard-coded inputs, hard-coded output only. Array, instead of waiting for DAO to complete for days together, so it's a better option now, guys. Especially after 6 months, I am going to have tie up with the Paytm people. But I have to do service class completion today itself. Come on, guys. Service class completion today itself. A real transaction won't happen, guys. But our code is ready or not? Real transaction will happen when real database and real DAO is there. Anyhow, testers will do, na? This is not final test, guys. Who said this is final test? Okay, real functionality will be tested by whom? Testers are there. If they are also there, one testing will happen at the same time. At the same time, after releasing project, user acceptance test will be there. There also real functionality will be tested. But here we are temporarily testing, boss. I hope you are understanding. At the time of integration test, anyhow, real functionalities will be tested. Don't think that forever real functionality is not tested. We are reducing the dependency. If someone is not ready, we should not block ourselves, right? If someone is not ready, we should not block ourselves. We are going by that. I hope you are understanding my point. Guys, okay, let it be, guys. Right, now I'm going for at the rate test. How to make it? How to write it? At the rate test. Copy this, guys. Paste it. Test login with invalid credentials. Rani 1. Then I am asking to provide 0. I'm asking to provide 0, right? Assert false. Assert false. Here also I will give Rani 1. Control plus shift plus. Control plus static import I'm asking to have. Next, valid test with no credentials. Test login with no credentials. With no credentials. Okay. That time there is no need of this dummy mock object and all this stuff, guys. No, there is another way of testing it. What is the another way of testing it, guys? Assert throws. Assert throws. Assert throws. Come on, guys. Assert throws. Expected is what? Illegal argument exception dot class. Okay, illegal argument exception dot class. Are other day we discussed, guys. Last session we discussed. Okay, tell me here what is this. Login service dot login. Tell me empty string. Login service dot empty string, end of the floor bracket semicolon, right, guys? Assert to throws, it should give me exception whether it is coming or not. Are you understanding my point there? Okay. Okay, guys. Yes, am I correct here? Okay, we have written all the three test cases or not? Yes, guys. Tell me here. Run as J unit. Run as J unit. See, count to one, count to zero. Two times that method is called in two test methods. Count to one, count to zero, and J unit. Three test cases and three successes. Observe. Valid credentials, no credentials, invalid credentials. I hope you enjoyed this one, guys. Today, without DAO, we have completed testing on service class by creating mock object. Sir, why should I believe their mock object is created as in-memory class? Don't believe me. Believe my practicals. Sys out. Sys out. Login DAO mock dot get class. Login DAO mock dot test class. Okay, fine. You can keep all time limits, all the things. Whatever you learned in JUnit, all the things can be applied. No problem. Right? Time limit is related to which method, guys? Service class method. Why are you bringing mock into picture? Okay, right. Login DAO mock dot get class, and let me prove that it is implementing our ilogin DAO interface. Arrays dot to string, arrays dot to string, login DAO dot mock dot get interfaces, get class dot get interfaces, get class dot get interfaces. Now you observe. Run JUnit test. Run JUnit test. See, guys. Login DAO dollar markito mark dollar some number. Some number. This class is there in our computer. This class is there in our project. Not there. Not there. It's a dynamically generated in-memory class, guys. Dynamically generated in-memory class. Sure, sir. Yes. And it is implementing so many interfaces, but one interface is ilogin DAO. One interface is ilogin DAO. I'm not showing hash code, I'm showing the class name. Definitely object is there, that's why you're able to invoke the methods, right? Get class will give me class name. I hope you are understanding my point there. Everyone got the clarity? Everyone got the clarity? So I'm just pasting this one, guys. Okay, I'm pasting this one, guys. Look at this. Right. Right. So mock generates in memory class implementing logging DAO interface having null method definition for authentication method. Yes or no? Right. And already I have explained what is in memory class, what is normal class, what is the difference between and all this stuff. We discussed a not a right. Okay, guys. Fine. So we have added this Jarna Markito core. In this core only this Markito class is there. Since that is a static method, guys, in all these places You can go for static imports and we can make code more beautiful. We can just call mock method. There is no need of writing Mockito. Here also, there is no need of writing Mockito. Understanding my statement, guys? I think you understood the difference between mock and static import. One problem is there, it reduces code readability because we cannot feel that class belongs to, that method belongs to which class. That's why I'm keeping for a few days. But once you got practice, once you got enough knowledge, like assert triple X methods, start using static imports. Start using static imports. Everyone got the clarity, guys? Come on. Right. Fine, boss. So this is stub object and mock object, guys. Everyone got the clarity now? Right. So now what I want to do is I just want to give one small example showing the difference between spy object and mock object. Then I will link that knowledge with here. First, you try to feel the difference between spy object and what? Mock object. Then I will feel the difference. I will try to link with our example. So here I will take a small class, guys. Okay. What is this? Mock versus spy test. This is POC kind of example. POC kind of example. Please feel it. I will take one predefined class to explain this. Private list string. Private list string. First, you see this example, then I will come with. Okay. Here I am taking mock list is equal to mock list. Empty string here, guys. Otherwise, why to create here? We can create inside this only, na? Right. So we'll go for public wide test. Test list. I have to take two variables here. List string. Come on, guys. What I should do? List string. Mock. List string. List mock. List mark is equal to you can do marking on predefined classes also. It's not like that. Then what should I do, guys? Mockito dot mock. What is the method I should pass, guys? What is the one I have to pass? List dot class. What dot class, guys? List dot class. Or you can pass array list dot class. That's up to your comfort, not an issue. Okay. Array list dot class. Fine, boss. Array list dot class. List string, list of spy. List string, list spy. Mockito dot mock. Mockito dot mock. Mockito dot mock. Yes, here also instead of mock, I'm taking one more method called spy. One more method called spy. Right. Okay. Here there is a possibility of passing object also. I hope understanding my point there. Okay, guys. Here I'm passing new array list of. See, boss, here I passed class. Here I passed, guys. I hope you are understanding my point. Here I have passed class. Here I have passed list collection. Are you seeing it? I'm passing real object. Are you noticing it, guys? Okay, fine, boss. Now you observe list mark dot add one element. What is that? Table. List mark dot add table. Okay, fine. Next, list spy dot add. List spy dot add table. List spy dot add table. Okay. Now you observe. Right, guys. I'm trying to find out list mark dot size. I'm calling which method? Size method. List mark dot size. Right. I'm also calling one more method. What is this? List spy dot. List spy dot size. I'm just writing at the rate test method. Okay, no test, nothing, guys. I'm just writing at the rate test method. Focus now. Run on JUnit test, guys. Run on JUnit test. Observe very carefully. When I call list spy dot size, one has come. Come on, not index numbers, worst fellows. Their index numbers are. They are not index number. I am printing element sizes. Please focus. Otherwise, take rest and attend next time. Did I present them as index numbers? Focus, guys. Focus. Someone typing index numbers are. They are index numbers are. No hair size. Listen, boss. List mark dot size zero. List mark dot size zero. I said na, when marking is happened, all the methods of class will be implemented doing nothing. All the methods of that class will be implemented doing nothing. Null method definitions, I said, right? So that's why when I call add method, any functionality is happening, guys. When I call add method, any functionality is happening, guys. No functionality is happening. Did I provide any stub definition for that method? Did I provide any stub definition for that method? No. Did I provide any stub definition for that method? No. That's why what? Nothing is happening. That's why size has given what? Zero only. Okay, but when it comes to add method, please observe, when it comes to add method, so since real method is not there, since overridden stub method is not there, it is using real method or not, on the real object that we provided or not. It is using real method on the real object that we provided. Did you notice it? Did you notice it, guys? At least you understood the difference between. And moreover, look at the mark method. Look at the mark method signature. In mark method signature, there is a provision to pass only class object. That means only classes we can pass. No provision to pass the real object. Is there any provision to pass the real object, guys? Is there any provision to pass the real object? Look at the magnifier I'll keep. No. Okay, that's why we have to think about always passing class only. One or other. Class only. Understanding my point. Okay. But you look at the signature of this spy method, guys. Class option is there. Next one. object option is there. That means we can pass real object here or not. We can pass real object here or not. That's the reason I am passing real object. So what happens? So what happens, guys? Whenever invoked method is not there on the spy object, it will use real object. We can link with real object. That's why it is called half mark object, partial mark object. I hope you are understanding my statements here. It is half mark object or partial mark object. See the beauty. It is linked with the class. It is totally mark class. But this is what? Partially mark. Partially mark. Understanding my statement? Okay, guys. Now, I want to provide some functionality for... I want to provide some functionality for... I want to provide some functionality for... where is this? I want to provide some mark object with some overridden functionality is nothing but stub, guys. Stub, we cannot mark object. Already we have felt in the previous example what is stub. Come on, guys. Right, guys. Okay, now listen here. Markito dot when. Okay, when? Tell me. List mark dot size method is called. What is this? Size method is called. Then return. List mark dot size method is called. Then return some 10, I said. Then return. Okay. Then return some 10, I said. Then return some 10, I said. Are you understanding my statement? List mark dot list method is called. Then I said 10. Then I said some 10. Okay. Now you observe. Now this is nothing but stubbing. This is seriously nothing but what? Stubbing. Semicolon here also. Yes, let's have a look on it. Run on J unit test. Okay, right now. Now what is coming? 10. 10, 10 and 1. 10 and 1. Okay, now it is stubbing na. Okay, this is example for mark guys. This is example for spy guys. Okay, this is example for spy. This is example for stub. This is example for stub. Are you understanding my statement, guys? Are you getting my point there or not there? Are you feeling the stub story here or not there? Okay. Now, sir. I want to do stubbing on spy object. I would like to do stubbing on spy object. To do stubbing on spy object, stub on mark. To do stubbing on what? Spy object. And we should call one more method, guys. Do return. We have to think about going for what? Do return. What is that? 10. Do return 10 for what method call, guys? For what method call? Do return 10 when what is this? List spy dot. Are you understanding my point? Size method is called. Do return 10. Yeah, we cannot use when for this spying. If you want to perform stub operation on spy object, you have to call do return only. Now you observe, run as J unit test. Are there no output? Why there is no output, guys? Do return 10. No, where I can print, it is not allowing to print anything behind in future release. You should allow me, na? Use due return. No typecasting, nothing is required. When list spy dot size is called, you should return 10. You should return 10. Yes. No, there is no need of. There is no need of. Here I am printing na system dot out dot println and list size dot spice. Do return 10. Do return 10. No, it is not required. It is not required. It is not required. We can do like this only. Once run the test method and failure comes. No, it is, we are running test method only, guys. Okay, let's go there. Red color. Okay, we'll see what is the problem. Unfinished stubbing exception. Unfinished stubbing expected, then return is missing. Oh, fine. Right. That okay. Then return. Okay, it's our mistake. No, actually, do return 10 is there. Na, do return 10 is there. Markito dot do return. Yes, it is static import, guys. It is going for static import. It is going for static import. Let's see. Then return is missing. Missing then return. You are trying to stub final method which is not supported. Okay, we are trying to stub hints. You are stubbing behavior. Another mark inside the then return instruction is completed. But I should not go for it na, because do return is already there. Okay, let me try this only. List mark dot size this. Okay, list spy. List size, list spy. Right. Run on JUnit test. Okay, fine. I thought of showing one more angle. Now you observe, boss. I'm doing spying. Okay. Marking on spy object or not. See these guys. Okay. Now what? Stub on spy object. Stub on spy object. Stub on mark object. Okay. Once again, I'm running. Everyone, please observe how much I got, guys. 10 and 10 I got. No, I thought of showing one more angle. Okay. No problem. And we are getting 10 and 10. Okay. Someone asked me, sir, I don't pass real object. Then what happens? Here also I will pass the class only. It is same, behaves like a mock object, guys. It behaves like a mock object only. I hope you are understanding my point. If you don't pass a real object, it behaves like a mock object. Then comment these two things. Comment this one also. And everything is basically mock object here. Don't forget that. JUnit test. Oh. Then also it's good. Okay, it is taking real object. That's good. Okay, fine, boss. Array list dot class. Yes, it internally creates a predefined class. Na? Since it's a predefined class, it internally creating what? Object and using that size. Not a problem at all. So, but what is most important here is whether it is spy object is internally using real object or not, that is very, very important. I hope you got the clarity, guys. You can write like this or you can also pass like this. That's up to you. Okay, that's up to you. Right. List spy is equal to, yes, here I am taking this one also. New array list. Okay, guys. Array list. Since it is a predefined class, are you understanding my statement? Okay, it's a predefined class. It internally creating object. Then also output is one. Actually, I thought it is won't come, but it is a predefined class. It has got the capability of creating what? Taking class and creating object. I hope you are understanding my point. No, mock and spy both are not same. Amit Yadav, you have not observed properly. Okay, mock is different, spy is different. Is that clear, guys? What mock will do? Mock method will give mock object by creating what? In-memory class, implementing methods with no functionalities. Understanding my point? When it comes to, but if you want to provide functionality, you have to go for stub. We have to go for stub. Are you understanding, guys? Right. When it comes to what? Spy object. It creates mock object linked with real object. So if you don't provide any stub functionality for the method, okay, it internally uses real object. It seriously internally uses real object. So that is the difference between mock object and spy object and stub object. I think you connected to this one nicely, na? Okay. Copy this. Go here. Say paste. Right, guys. So already I have given statements on it. Okay, na? Already I have given statements on it. Okay. Here what? 10 and 10 will come. No doubt in that. Here we are going to get 10 and 10. Okay. If Markito dot when method statements are not commented. Not commented. Otherwise, what you will get here? 0 and 1. When, guys, are commented. Okay, guys, now listen carefully. Spy objects are useful. To check how many times methods are called. Whether they are called or not. How many times methods are called. Whether they are called or not. This is extra behavior. Because spy object. Is always linked with. Come on. Always linked with real object. always linked with real object. Yes, this is one extra provision we are having. So you want to test that? Let me give that knowledge also. So I want to use, okay, for this we have to use Markito.verify method. For this use, don't relax. We are in the peak stage of learning. No one will give clarity on spy object, mock object, stub object at this level. I hope you are understanding. You got clarity on mock. You go and ask anyone, what is the difference between spy, mock and what? Stub object. In the internet also, so much confusion is going on. Come on. For that purpose, we have to use what? Verify method. Markito.verify method. Right. Right. Okay. So this is taken for test purpose, boss. Now let's come back to our story. What is our story, guys? What is our story? I'm taking new method in the service class. I'm taking new method in the DAO, new method in the service class. Fine, guys. Public. What is this? Public. Tell me here, guys. Public. So here we are having one method called save method. Save method. Actually, I want to register user. Okay. For register user, there will be one method called add user. Add user. Add user means what? Successful insertion will be there. So here I am taking one method called register user. Okay. I am taking one word called add user. String user, comma. Okay, string user, comma. Then what is next, guys? Add user, string user, comma, string role. String role. String user, comma. This is the method we are having, guys. Right. Now come to this service class. Come to the service class. Here I'm taking one method called string register user. What user here? Register user. Right. Now listen, I'm trying to go one more angle of spy object, guys. So register user. Tell me here. Register user. String user, string role. Okay. I have a condition in my register method. What is that condition, you know? What is that condition, you know? If a user is not having role and user is having visitor role, I don't want to store them in the database because they are allowed anyhow. All people are allowed. All people are allowed. I hope you are understanding my point. Yes. So let's see here. If not role equals ignore case, role equals ignore case empty string, or if not, R I end, end. Okay. Role equals ignore case, role equals ignore case. Everyone, please focus. Okay, what is this? Visitor. Role equals ignore case. What is there, guys? Visitor. Okay, right. And then what is this? I am asking him to go for DAO method call. What is the method call? DAO method call. What is this? Login DAO dot add user of user comma role. Add user comma role. So if not, okay, then I want to do what operation? Return user added. Return user added. One message, what? User added. If not, come on. If not, login DAO dot, okay, user not added, user not added. Here I am taking word user added. Everyone enjoyed my point, guys? Come on. Right. See, I'm calling add user method on condition basis. Are you observing, guys? I'm calling add user method on condition basis. Are you observing that, guys? Are we noticing that, guys? Are we observing that point? Are we noticing that point? That's good. Okay. Now listen, I'm writing one test method, public void test. What is this? Public void test. Public void test. Test. What is that? Resistor. Test resistor. Test resistor with the spy. With the spy. Okay, how to make it test method, guys? At the rate test. At the rate test. Okay, now listen. I don't want to use the objects that came in setup once. Because here this object came with what object? Mark. I want to use with what? Spy. So if you want to use for spy, better to go for what? One more reference variable. Better to create separate reference variable, separate spy object here or not there. How to create, guys? Login DAO. What DAO? Login DAO. Login DAO. I login DAO spy. I login DAO. What is this? Login DAO spy. Login DAO spy is equal to. Tell me here. Login DAO spy is equal to. Okay, here what is this? Markito dot. Markito dot spy. Markito dot spy. We don't have a real class. That's why what I am taking. I login DAO dot class. I login DAO dot class. Super. We are ready with the spy object, guys. What is this? Typecasting. Why no? Not required. I login. I login DAO dot class. Okay. Now what is this? I am also taking I login management service. Okay, login service is equal to new. Come on. Login management service IMPL. Okay, what is this? Login DAO SPY. Okay, login DAO SPY. Because I'm just trying to create a new service object here. On this service object, listen carefully. Login service dot, what is that? Register user. What user, guys? Register user. Did I not declare register user method in login management service? Okay, maybe not declared. So that's why it is not allowing me to create call, because interface should have a method declaration now, guys. All right. Save paste. Done, boss. Okay. Now come over here. Come over here. Yes, come over here. Login service dot register user. Raja role is. What is that? Admin. Raja role is admin. Next, register user Suresh. Role is visitor. Yes, login service dot, this is different type of testing, guys. Okay. Next one, empty string. Okay, name. Okay, user is Johnny, no role. Johnny, no role. Yes, guys, I want to check how many times what method add user method is called in DAO class. For that purpose, we are having Mockito dot. This is a different kind of testing. Behavior testing we can do. Mockito dot verify. Mockito dot verify. Listen carefully. Right. What is this? Mock. What mock object? Mockito dot verify. So what is your spy object now? The spy object is login DAO spy. That's fine. Login DAO spy. And here, verify. Actually, there is one more. There is a parameter here. Overloaded parameter. What happened? Verify verification mode. Verify verification mode. TMock. TMock. Where are those overloaded methods, guys? We need that overloaded methods. Login DAO dot spy. Login DAO dot spy. We are having lot of methods, guys. Lot of methods we are having. 1 minute. I'm just looking for one verification one. One verification one. Yes, guys. Login DAO dot spy, comma. 1 minute. Mockito dot, see, there is a method. There are so many methods, guys. Times method is there, na? What is the method we are having? Times. Times method. Did you notice it, guys? Times. Never. At most. At least. We can check. Okay, first let me go for times. You will get idea. Times. Times of. Okay, zero. Times of zero dot. Times of zero dot. What is the method? Add user, Raja comma, admin. Oh, I'm going wrong. If I call add user method, if, okay, it should be called one time. Raja admin is there, add user should be called one time. Understanding my statement. Okay, fine. Times zero, if I call this method with Suresh comma, what is this? Visitor. I think you are understanding this statement. Are add user method is called with Suresh and visitor. It should be called zero times. It should be called zero times. Come on. Instead of writing zero times, we have one more method called Mockito dot never. What is the meaning of never? At least times zero. At least alias to times zero. We can also call the never. Add user dot Jani comma empty string. Jani comma empty string. That means when I call register methods like this, add user method is called or not called to verify that it is very, very useful or not. Please, please don't give up to verify that it is very useful for behavioral or not. See this Raja admin internally calls add user. I'm checking one time called or not. Suresh visitor. What is that? Suresh visitor. Add user will not be called in the service method. So I'm checking zero times called or not. Jani empty string should not be called. I'm checking whether really called or not called. Okay, guys. So anyhow, first three tests are positive. Let's see whether fourth test is positive or not. JUnit test, guys. JUnit test. Okay, we got a green color. And fourth one is also positive. Fourth one is also positive. I hope you are understanding. This is the real-time use case of what? Spy method. Spying, because we need original functionality. We want to check how many times that method is called, whether called or not. For that particular purpose, instead of using mock object, better to use what? Spy objects. Because pi objects are something like this. If they are not there, they will be using what? Real object functionality. That's why better to use what? This one. 71 to 73. Very simple, guys. Take this spy object, call add user method. Okay. Raja, comma, admin. See, when you are executing these methods, Raja admin is called for one time or not. Yes, called. While executing this method, Suresh visitor means when I pass Suresh visitor, add user method should be called zero times. Yes, happened or not happened. Next, never means zero times. Marketo dot add user Jani method means it should be called zero time when Jani and empty string is given. Clear, guys? See, these are the business method internally calls add user method. Come on, guys. I am checking while calling these methods, understanding my point there, right? Okay. When Raja admin is there, add user is called for one time or not in these calls. Yes. Test positive. Visitor and this one called zero times or not. Yes. Because this register user method is internally calling what people are. That's why I asked to study completely. I am calling add user method in service class on condition basis. When that condition is satisfied, then only it will add user is called. So add user should called for zero times for inputs zero, Suresh and visitor happened or not. Add user should be called, never should not be called. If for the input Jani and empty string happened or not. If all things are happening, okay. Test result is positive. Something is not matching, test result negative. I hope you are understanding my statement, guys. Forget about that count. Think about this one. We got this one. Shiva Durgi, I hope you got clarity now. Right, guys. Here is my what? Raja, comma, admin, guys. Here is my Raja, comma, admin. So checks in the above register method calls in the above register method calls. Come on. In the above register method calls, add user is method is called for one time internally or not for the inputs Raja, comma, admin. This is purely for this line only. Right, guys. Suresh visitor register method is not calling add user method. Check it out. Please watch the service class code, Ra Worst Fellows. If it is visitor, am I calling add user method? Akshay Bhuse. If it is visitor, role is visitor, am I calling add user method? Fine. Please just keep the service class method also in mind, guys. Right, guys. Now, listen carefully. Now, I want to develop the same thing through annotations. Annotations definitely simplifies our code, guys. No doubt in that. Shall we develop same thing through annotations, guys? Marketo with annotations. I want to develop Marketo with what? Annotation. Shall we start doing that work now? Okay. So here, new. Where is this? Class. Login management service test. Service test NO. service test, yeah, no annotations I want to use. Won't take much time, guys. Very easy to do that. Okay, whatever code is there here, I copy paste this code, guys. Whatever code is there here, I copy paste this code. Come here, paste this code. Now this I want to convert into annotations. This is my requirement. This is my requirement. Shall we start doing that work now? Very simple, guys. Okay. So now forget about this setup one and other things. Setup one and before all these things. Okay, if you want, you can go for clear all ones. Here, you want to get mock object for this, at the rate mock over. It will give the mock object. So in a stance variable, I just want to use a non-static method. That's why I'm taking this. Right? You are interested to get spy object? No problem. You are interested to get spy object? Okay. We have a at the rate spy. We have a direct method called what? At the rate spy. I'll come to spy part later. Okay. Now, sir, this mock object should be injected to service class now. Okay. Take IMPL class, guys. No doubt in that. Take IMPL class. Here, there is a method called inject mocks. Inject mocks. Right. No, sorry. Login management service IMPL. Login management. Class. Using constructor, it will inject. You are least bother about it. Really, sir? Yes, guys. Okay. Login DAO mock is equal to null. Okay. They are not taken static. Fine. Let's not clear. If you don't clear, not a problem at all. Yes, guys. So for the timing, let me comment this spy method. Okay. Let me comment that spy method. But one thing we should do, guys, what is that? You know, you should tell there are annotation. That's why I'm taking constructor here. I'm calling one method. Mockito annotations dot init mock is there, but somehow it is deprecated. Other place, this you pass. Open mocks this. Are you understanding my point there? Right. Listen, at the rate mock gives mock object. At the rate inject mocks to the service class. To the service class, other mock objects will be injected. Come on. This much clearly is there. This is not to give mock objects. This is to perform injection of the mock objects. Understanding my statement? Okay. Mockito annotations. Injection means assigning. Mockito annotations. Right. At the rate mock. To generate mock object. At the rate spy. To generate spy object. To generate spy object. Right. Next, at the rate inject mocks to inject. What is this? Mock or spy objects to mock or spy objects to service class. Service class. Are you understanding my point, guys? Come on. Right. Fine, boss. So I have method. Only three methods are there. Right. This is very important. Mockito dot open marks this. Then only this method only will start initializing annotation. Will start recognizing annotation. You must call this method in order to activate the annotation. Okay. Call this method. in at the rate before or constructor of, okay, test case class, tell me, in order to activate Marketo annotations. In order to activate Marketo annotations. In order to activate Marketo annotation. Now let's have a look now. Run as JUnit, save OK. We got success or not? I want reply, guys. Everything is same, guys. Only these annotations are important. Sir, I want to get spy object also. I log in DAO spy. Here what? @spy. Okay. @spy. Here one problem is there. What is that problem? You know, here ambiguity problem may come. Check it out. Okay. Since I created spy there, let's come back. Okay, let me bring my method. I think I should lose all the things. I lost. These comments are bad, guys. Okay, fine. I'll bring my code back. Then I will comment manually. Right. Okay. Now I will add all the annotations. Tell me what is this? Marketo annotations dot open marks, because open marks test class means test case class you have to pass, right? This guys, test class, this, right? Here I'm taking this one, guys, @spy. Okay, here also I am taking spy. Since the spy object is here, I stopped creating spy object there, right? Since service is already there at the reference variable, let us assume I stopped creating. Okay. Here login service is there. Here also login service is there. Why it is not visible, guys? Why it is not visible? Login service. Okay, spell mistake. Fine. Service. Okay, one practical problem is there, guys. To this type, this is eligible to inject. This is also eligible to inject. Come on, guys. So JUnit test. Definitely red color. What is the red color? Expected true, but it was false. Invalid credentials. Are you observing that? Login management. Login test with spy. Login test with spy. Why first one only failed, sir? First one also should be successes, na sir? Okay, let's analyze. Okay, here what's happening? Authenticate Raja Rani, then return one. Service long asset true. But why it is giving false, guys? Nothing is there. Properly not injected, guys. This one is properly not injected. Are you understanding my statement? Things are not properly injected because ambiguity problem has come. Check it out. This is ready to inject to service class. Even this is also ready to inject to service class. Now you comment this one. You comment this one. You comment this one. Okay. You also comment this one. There is no problem at all. You comment both, there is no problem at all. But when I keep both the things, it is in confusion state. Because we have one param constructor, spy object is ready to inject. Come on. Spy object is ready to inject. And also what? DAO object also ready to inject. Did you notice it, guys? Spy object is ready to inject and DAO object also ready to inject. Did you observe that, guys? Come on. And both are mock objects. So that's why in this situation, we cannot use @spy. Okay. That's why what we have to do, better to create DAO spy object and service class objects manually only. What, guys? Manually only. In the test method itself directly. Why? Because when we created the top, it is giving ambiguity problem. Because spy object is eligible for injection and mock object is eligible for injection to the service class. And it is giving some ambiguity issues. Okay, now I solved that. Now you observe this. JUnit, guys, and happily we are getting green color. It's not like that we cannot use a spy, @spy. We can use. But in this situation, other methods are expecting spy object and ours is expecting mock object. Are you understanding my point? So that's why ambiguity is coming and service is ready to take only one object. So ambiguity problem is coming. Injections are not happening properly. Okay. That's why. Yeah. Reverse also fine. That's up to you. Reverse also you can do. So sir, can we go for reverse? Comment, mark and use spy. Your choice. But when you comment, mark, in every test method, you have to create mock object manually. Here you have to create mock object. Fine. So that's the reason I am doing like this, guys. Okay, here is the code. Here is the sample code, guys. Say paste. Okay, for knowledge sake, I am not commenting it. I'm giving the feeling it is there. Otherwise, let it be. Keep the feeling of comment only. Yes. 1 minute. I want to give along with the class. Test case class. I hope everyone enjoyed this one, guys. Right. So this is how working with annotation. No doubt, lot of code will be reduced, boss. Annotations driven Marketo programming code will be reduced. So your choice. I have given both knowledge. Whatever you want, you can use it. And one more small thing I want to teach in Marketo. That small thing is BDD methods, guys. BDD methods. For example, you take this one only. You take this. Instead of this, there are BDD. What is that? Behavior driven development. Okay. I think anyone's attended my Agile workshop. I said in Agile workshop class, there will be user stories and user stories will be given on this condition. What is that? In this given situation, when this data is given, this output should come. User stories, Agile user stories, and there will be one format, boss, while writing Agile user stories. For this given situation, when this data is given, then this output should come. Okay. Given when then. Okay. No problem. Listen carefully. we are supporting that kind of terminology. We have got BDD methods to generate the stub, guys. We have a BDD methods. Okay, you want to see that kind of methods? Okay, this is the given situation. Given method call. What is the method call, guys? Login DAO mock dot authenticate. Username is Raja. Authenticate. Username is Raja. Okay. Password is Rani. Okay. Then will return. It improves readability. Someone asked the other day, sir, this then return, will return will always give integer values. Not like that, guys. They can give multiple answer. Will answer, will return, integer, will throw. Like this, we have a lot of option. Will return, what is that one? Okay, boss. BDD means behavior driven development. Are nothing is there. Alternate for this, guys. Only Makito will do this kind of thing. This is what BDD. It is actually given by developing what? Will return one. Okay, that's it. Same, it is alternate for these guys. BDD Makito dot. Now you observe, run JUnit test. Again, you will get the positive only. So what I want to tell is, first, alternate one, guys. To write stub functionality, according to Agile user stories. Okay, if needed, I kept videos of Jira and Agile in the net. Go for it. Okay, guys. Agile user stories or Jira user stories. What is the basic one here? Given in this given situation, for when this method is, when this inputs are given, and this, then this output should come. Okay. In a login screen. Come on. In a login screen. When valid credentials are given, then email screen should come. Something like this. In a login environment, when invalid credentials are given, I should get error page. Like this, we write user stories. Product manager or what? Builder, be a business analyst. We'll write the user stories by using Jira tool, guys. So to support that environment, we have got this stuff. That's it. So this is first one. This is second one. Okay. Right, guys. This is equal to this. Everyone understood my point, guys? Come on. Are you with me? Right. With these, we completed Makito discussions, guys. Everyone enjoyed Makito? At least you understood what is marking? Everyone got the clarity about marking? Yes, right. Okay. Okay, already you have heavy, yeah? Should I teach HTTP unit also? That needs 45 minutes to 1 hour. Some other day we will see, or today itself. Okay, majority people are saying some other day. Okay, you practice Makito. Some other day I will conduct what? HTTP unit. Tomorrow I cannot assure, because if I keep class morning 7 a.m. no one will come. I know that. Okay, some other day I will plan and I will let you know. Because tomorrow morning 7 a.m. I can take. But I don't think how many people will turn up. No, 10 a.m. not possible. I have other works. Okay, tomorrow is Sunday. No regular classes. Next classes will be on Monday. Fine. I think you got, I hope you benefited with Makito, guys. I hope you understood what is Makito. You thoroughly enjoyed what is Makito. Good. Should I continue this kind of workshops? Right. Actually, one small topic is left, half an hour to 45 minutes. HTTP unit. Okay. One day I will announce and I will take that session. Don't worry about it. One day I will announce, I will take that session. Not a big issue. Offline classes. Modi and Chief Minister together should take the decision. Akshay Bhuse, MongoDB will be conducted along with the Spring Data module. Okay, it takes time to habituate with API. Takes time. This video will be uploaded within 1-2 days. Yes, other workshops also will be conducted. Log4j, Docker, Jenkins, debugging. So many things are there. One by one, we will discuss. Fine. Yeah, these things will be done by every developer, boss, in real time, to avoid the dependency among the programmers, to complete the task and to complete the unit testing. Definitely. Fine. Array, instead of Bigbucket, we are using Git, boss. Git is industry standard. Yeah, you can happily keep Makito tool in your resume. Makito JUnit tools in the resume. You can happily keep. Definitely. Fine, guys. Thank you, guys. Okay, I will announce the time, date and time of HTTP unit in the group also. Don't worry about it. I'm attending Spring 6 p.m. Until you got Spring MVC, better not to keep resume Spring in the resume. Freshers, not a problem. Summer, to make people to use their choice module, they wantedly given as 20 modules. because all projects may not use all modules, na? That's why they divide into 20 modules. Fine guys. Alia, after getting 6-7 years experience on Java, then think about data science. Initially not required. CRT course is not required for experienced people. Vikash Malik, I have uploaded 20 modules diagrams. No, 20 modules discussion is related to Spring. You don't worry, boss. Siddharth Gupta, whatever modules I have highlighted in the classroom, whatever modules you practice, you can keep them in there. Bindu Sravanti, once you complete MVC, think about it. Vikas Deepak, contact admin for XML web service badge. I think it was right. Right. Tomorrow no classes, guys. Tomorrow no classes. HTTP Unity is there. I will announce and I will conduct that session. Don't worry. Follow the group. In the follow group, I will update the information. Thank you, guys. Have a nice time. If you are looking for any new batches, contact Mr. Admin. His number is shared to you people. 2009 year of pass out, 2021. Yes, since 2020, rate of recruitment is not done. Till 2021, June, July, you will be treated as fresher. Still 2021, June, July, you will be treated as fresher. Thank you, guys. We'll meet on Monday for regular classes. Have a nice time.